Okay, and so this one is the opposite of the groups one. So in this one, I have part of something. I want to know what the entire thing is going to equal. So just like in class, we had an example that said that 10 is equal to n over 4. Now, what's important is going back to what does this n over 4 actually means? Now, a lot of you may think, okay, well, it's n split up into 4. Yeah, that's pretty true. But I can write this in a different way, can't I? I know that n over 4 is the same as a fourth of n, right? Or a quarter of n, right? And this one I'm actually going to draw out. So just keep that in mind there. I have a balance, and remember, I like my balances because these are easy to draw. On the left side here, I have 10. So I'm just going to draw in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. On the right side, I have n, right? I have n, but do I have a full n? No, I don't have a full n. I have a quarter of it. Or if this is my n, it is divided into fourths. And how many of the fourths do I have? I have one fourth of this. So I have this one fourth here. Now, knowing that, we can use logical reasoning that if this one fourth is equal to 10, that means this fourth is equal to 10, that fourth is equal to 10, this fourth is equal to 10. So all fourths are equal to 10. So if one fourth is equal to 10, then four fourths must equal to 10 four times. Right? And that's exactly what we're doing here. So over here, I can say I don't need one fourth. I need the one fourth, two fourths, three fourths, or four fourths to get the whole thing. Or I need one fourth, one, two, three, four times. And that's exactly what we're going to show here. So if I have 10 is equal to n over 4, I'm going to take this whole thing and I'm going to multiply it by 4. Now, when I multiply it by 4, that means I have 1, 2, 3, 4. In order to keep this balance, I have to multiply the other side by 4 as well. And so what's going to happen here is I have 40 is the same as 4n over 4. Now, of course, 4n over 4, 4 divided by 4 is in fact 1, and I'll prove that why. 4n over 4 is the same as, if I remember my distributive property, sorry, not my distributive property. If I remember my fraction properties, that this here, it can be the same as 4 out of 4 times n. So 4 over 4 times n, which is the same as 1 times n, which is the same as n. So all this simplifies down to 40 is equal to n. Or you can just simply remember 4 divided 4 is 1. This whole thing is 1n. Okay, and there you have it. I've just taken a part of a variable and found out that the entire variable is equal to 40. Hope that helps. And in the last one, we're going to be looking at opposites.